In this Power Fab Tips and Tricks video, we're going to look at some interactions between Tekla EPM and Trimble Connect, hopefully to give you some ideas of how to make your shop more productive in your day-to-day operations. First, we'll look at how EPM can colorize the model to help you visualize information from EPM. This works from either estimating or production control. For this demonstration, we'll look at a production control project. So in this case, I have a production control job where we can colorize the model based on data like category, subcategory, drawing approval status, material status, or production, shipping, and field status. We also have the ability to interact between the data in production or estimating and the model. Once the Trimble Connect model is open, right-click the bill of material display in EPM to access these controls. Selecting model allows you to clearly identify an assembly or part location in the model. There's also the option to enable auto-selecting model, so you could step through different assemblies and parts and select and zoom to them in the model. Select from the model and auto-select from the model will select within Tekla EPM the part, or if you have enabled the object selection mode, this square with the 4 points on the corners, the assembly items in Trimble Connect. The filter from model option can filter in the EPM bill of materials just the assemblies or parts that you select in the model. This option may be helpful if you need reports or production status for a particular location in the project. You can filter from the model and apply that filter to your reports. The isolate in model option allows you to view only the selected item. This can be helpful in situations where it's difficult to understand a geometry just by looking at the drawings, and can help with the layout and fit-up process. In most projects, the model is already detailed by phases, which typically are utilized as fabrication sequences. In those cases, you could also assign lot numbers to make the fabrication and erection process more organized and consistent. Let's colorize this model based on sequence, and for this demonstration, isolate just sequence 1 on the Trimble Connect display. Then in Tekla EPM, from the production control pull-down menu, we'll select the set sequences option. In the set sequences screen, you can create or edit the sequences or lot numbers for the assemblies. Instead of having a stack of erection drawings on your desk and searching for the marks that we want to fabricate, ship, and erect first, we'll use the model. Select the assemblies for the first lot. In EPM, select those assemblies by using Select from Model. Then set all these as lot number 1A. For the rest of the pieces on sequence 1, we'll set them as lot number 1B. As you can see, it's really quick and easy to designate either sequences or lots using the model for better planning. Another nice use for these tools is load planning. A requirement for this will be to have loads created in EPM so that then you can assign material on each one of those loads. Here we see that loads have already been created, so now we'll go back to the model in Trimble Connect and select some assemblies, either one by one. Or by area. And then in EPM, we can use Select from Model. Now with those assemblies selected, from the Production Control pull-down, under Modify Data, select Load All Selected. This shows our list of filtered items, so we can move all of those to the included side. Select the load number, and also note that here you can compare what's loaded to the truck's capacity. And if that's okay, click Add Material to add those to load one. Now in a scenario where the job site will determine what needs to be shipped, they could create a to-do in Connect with the desired assemblies linked, so that then, based on their selection in the to-do, the shop can click View Linked Objects, then use Select from Model, and perform the same process to add those pieces into a load. So they would follow the same process to select from model. And add those items to the next load. Note that if you only want to pre-assign material items at this point to the load and not actually load the items, you want to clear the Load on Assign checkbox in the lower left corner. Now we can colorize by shipping status and see items that have been assigned to a load. Hopefully this has given you some ideas on how you can utilize EPM and Trimble Connect to improve your workflow. Watch for more PowerFab tips and tricks videos delivered to you in your inbox each month.